TV set. Yeah. Doing all this. Oh, g'day, Bono. How's it going? Oh, thanks for getting back to me so quickly. Really appreciate that. Oh, hang on, another call. Hang on, wait a second. Oh, that's better. Yeah. So, need a big favour, man. Apparently, people aren't happy with the audio and the music. And so I thought, who better to call than my mate Bono and find out what can I do? Oh, you do that first, do you? Oh, okay. Here we go. Testing, testing. 1, 2, 3. Testing, testing. Don't know how that went. What else should you do? Oh, don't play the same song over and over again. You've got to mix the songs up. Okay. Yeah. And play the music really loud. Really, really loud. Okay, cool. Thanks, mate. I'll talk to you soon. Bye. That was my mate Bono. We go way back. Now that the audio has been adjusted, I hope that everyone can relax. If you're listening to YouTube with tiny inbuilt laptop speakers or on your phone, there's not much I can do to make it any better for you. But if you buy a good pair of headphones or external speakers, it will change your life. Today's topic is another old Sony chestnut that's been kicking around the internet for many years. Why does the color change in my videos after I rendered them with main concept AVC? The colors now look more saturated, slightly darker, and have a little bit more contrast. The first reaction some people normally have to discovering this effect is to completely freak out. I've actually seen people wearing sackcloth in the street, covering themselves with ash and wailing for hours, then threatening to start using Final Cut Pro. Seriously though, there are many contributing factors if you're seeing this effect, and it's not the fault of Sony Vegas. The first thing everyone should check is to make sure your computer monitor has been properly calibrated. If it isn't, you may think all the videos look perfect in Sony Vegas or Movie Studio, but the reality is everyone on your little island has purple skin and green hair. I can personally admit to having badly calibrated monitors. I was using Photoshop for years and couldn't work out why all the blues were purple. Then I discovered that the gamma controls in my monitor were completely set wrong. There is a basic calibration app built into Windows which you can use, and there are also special devices you can buy to calibrate for you. The next big thing that can make your videos look different after they've been rendered is what you use to play the video back with. Windows Media Player and YouTube's Player have a tendency to crush your blacks and whites, which makes everything look more contrasty and saturated. If you upload the exact same video to Vimeo, you'll see a different look again. Vimeo is definitely the best video service on the internet if you want to see close to perfect results. Other media players you can try are VLC Player, Real Player, QuickTime, CyberLynx, PowerDVD. What you will probably find is that the exact same video will look slightly different in each media player. If we jump back into Sony Vegas or Movie Studio for a moment, there are some things we can do to help normalize the video and produce better results. If you're really serious about producing great video, you need to apply some level of color correction to all your projects. The first most important thing is to make sure your white balance is set correctly. This is best done when you're actually filming your videos in your camera. By setting the white balance in the camera to the specific lighting condition, or color temperature is what they call it, you'll get the white balance to look much better. If you forgot to set the white balance in the camera, you can correct this in Sony Vegas by using the White Balance Video Effects plugin. It's pretty easy to use, just use the eyedropper tool. I actually have a complete beginner's guide tutorial on color correction, which I highly recommend everyone read and watch if you haven't already done so. I'll place a link in today's article on the website actually. The most important thing to note in regards to today's topic is that making your video broadcast safe will help produce better looking video on YouTube. My color correction tutorial shows exactly how to achieve this. If you have no time and patience for finessing your video productions before you render them, there is an easy hack you can apply to all your videos which will help to stop them looking darker on YouTube. You can apply a levels filter to the video output effects bus in Sony Vegas and Movie Studio. This button is found just above the preview window. When you add an effect here, it applies it equally to absolutely everything in the project. Find Sony levels and apply the computer RGB to studio RGB preset filter. This basically forces the project to be broadcast safe by bringing all the levels slightly down. It isn't perfect, but it does a good enough job for most people who like quick fixes. Okay, that's it for today. Now I'm gonna make a nice cup of tea and listen to Achtung Baby really loud. If you have no clue what I'm talking about, Achtung Baby is U2's best album ever, and it was recorded during the fall of the Berlin Wall. It's absolutely brilliant. See you later. I'll see you in the next video. See ya.